The pandemic has forced us to accept a new normal.
We stayed at home, but our journey has never stopped.
Welcoming the changes that came to our lives.
Limited opportunities and rights to proper education.
Brought divisions of accessibility among everyone.
But still, we aspired
to be reliable, responsible, and promising individuals.
We perspired.
Parents, teachers, and students.
Now, we inspire.
Together, hand in hand, to one goal.
To a reward well-deserved.
And well-earned.
25 years of excellence.
Minglanilla Science High School.
Good day to each and everyone who is attending virtually present at this time of our graduation ceremonies for our beloved and very precious graduates for the school year which ends at this time. First of all, I'd like to greet the parents and family members without whose sacrifices, whose reminders, and whose participation in the learning process for our graduates have resulted in this culmination program. This year, your role has changed drastically, where we've always believed that the matter of educating our children rests nearly exclusively on our teachers and our staff. This time, you parents, you family members, you who are in the households of our learners, have expanded your role and contributed to this wonderful day, wherein finally, our learners are graduating in this culmination exercise. So congratulations, because this year has not been very easy, has not been a picnic for our teachers, for our family members, as well, especially the parents, mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, and all who have contributed to the achievement of our learners at this time. So, maraming salamat at congratulations, parents and family members. Mas malaki ang role ninyo at this time compared to earlier graduation exercises. Secondly, I would also like to greet our teachers, without whose very careful review and careful supervision of the work of our pupils and our learners, this event would not be taking place at all. And so thank you, teachers. Your role has also expanded. In addition to seeing to it that the modules are faithfully followed, the assignments are correctly implemented, and the learners are truly learning, and you have had to deal with new ways of assessing the performance also of the learners. So congratulations, teachers, for enduring, for your patience, for your love for our learners, and your willingness to engage in a way and methods of teaching which are different from those which are used to. Assessment must have been especially difficult for you, especially since you were not able to see most of the time our students in face-to-face meetings. And most of the meetings, of course, were virtual. We'd also like to thank the local government units for their interest, for their cooperation, and for their continuing contributions to the needs of education, even as our children do not go to school. Your donations of material as well as financial resources at this time are most welcome, and your advice has been taken seriously, not only by our teachers, by our school officials, but also by our officials in the Department of Education. We continually talk with local government units, especially in times of disaster, in times of great need for classrooms, for space, and for responses to unforeseen emergencies. Thank you, local government units. But of course, most of the congratulatory greetings fall on the deserving graduate. Each and every one of you is truly special. You are different from the other graduates who have passed through the portals of your school. You went to school practically without seeing your teachers, if at all. You went to school with your parents, your mothers, and your fathers hovering over your shoulders and seeing to it that you are able to complete your assignments. You are completing your studies at a time when examinations and assessments are different. You are culminating this long months of hard work at this time, even as you have to do family chores, even as you are distracted, and even as your world has turned upside down, and it seems and it appears as if we don't know what the future holds and what will happen next. But you have persevered, and now you are ready to graduate. And therefore, you deserve each and every bit of congratulations from us in the Department of Education, from your parents and family members, your teachers, from the officials in local government, as well as in the parent-teachers associations. You deserve each and every single congratulatory pat on your back, each hug virtually, of course, and each greeting, which I am sure you are also receiving virtually. I don't know if you will remember this event many, many years from now. I have tried to recall myself who our graduation speaker was when I finished high school and when I finished my college studies. All I remember is that the graduation speaker was someone important, someone who was invited because that someone is supposed to give a message. What was more important to us graduates at that time was the excitement of the celebrations, the happiness and the joy of our parents, the sadness of parting from our classmates and from our teachers, and the enjoyment of all the graduation events that usually take place come commencement day. When I was a college student, we had a series of events which were designed to embed in our minds which were designed to help us remember and not forget our days in college. We would spend one whole day going around the campus, visiting the classrooms, saying goodbye to our teachers, and sharing memories. We would have bonfires to say goodbye to each other. We had baccalaureate services where we committed ourselves to God and we prayed for guidance when we go out into the world. So many celebrations, and the speaker, of course, is the least important and easily forgotten component of the graduation exercise. Nonetheless, I will exert all efforts to share with you what I see are things or issues which a graduate should remember and recall. I have said that you are very special. You are very different. You are pioneering. There has been no other class like your class. There has been no other graduate like you as a graduating student, because you are the very first graduate of the blended learning response to education in the Philippines. And so you ask yourself, what awaits you in the world outside? You can either work, because the kind of curriculum you survived and underwent as a student will enable you to go to work if you wish to go to work. Some of you will proceed to further studies, and this would be a wonderful thing because there are many opportunities for further expanding your knowledge, for further answering and looking for explanations of issues, events that make you curious, especially in science, in technology, and also in the arts. So you can work, you can go to further studies, and perhaps some of you will settle down, hopefully not too soon, so you can pursue what you really want to do. So today, this is why we call this exercise a commencement exercise. It's not the end of our studies. It's not the end of all our efforts with blended learning, with modules, with floods, with earthquakes, and of course, with COVID. It's a commencement of doors opening to you. More doors will be opened because you are a graduate. You can work, you can proceed for further studies, you can help your parents, and you can perhaps look for opportunities to do what you have always wanted to do, whether at work, whether at advanced studies, whether at learning more in science and technology, in mathematics, and in the arts. All of these opportunities are available to you. More doors are being opened. I hope you will select the door which arouses your curiosity, the door which will help you know more about this world, and the door which will allow you to contribute to the development of our country and contribute whatever we can to solve our problems and our challenges. Congratulations once more to each and every one of you. Congratulations to you, parents and family members. Congratulations to you, teachers. When I was chair of the board of Silliman University, each time we had graduation ceremonies during the baccalaureate and during commencement itself, I would cry. I would cry because you are sending out into the world a new batch of graduates, and we want to be sure that what is awaiting them is appropriate. We want to be sure that they are ready for what awaits them when they select which door to open. And so we tell you, go out to the world, do whatever you want to do. God be with you, and be sure, be assured that all of us love each and every one of you. Congratulations.
In one of the ordinary days of Minglanilla Science High School, there came this xerophytic entities that started sprouting to transpire energetic vibes in the low ground. They slowly stored and conserved the plume of diligence and mindful predicament to get up all the sorts of inscrutable antics to yearn for the waters of glorifying success out from the roller coaster yet fun-filled academic discussion and undying research task while battling with dozy head and dauntless competition of procrastination on attendance, projects, and long or short position essays. Then, suddenly came the abrupt digital convention of learning. Everyone was in great awe to indulge inside the virtual classroom of Zoom and Class Dojo. The overload strictness of book widgets, Google Forms, live worksheets during summative examinations, and the awkward virtual collaborated activities with Google Docs, Sheets, and the like, with which limitless turn-ins without attachments usually occurs. These real and imaginary atmospheres have further shaped their xerophytic attitude to outgrow their roots, to risk higher, to relentlessly obtain the dewy gift of massive victory and meaningful productivity from their huge temperament and wide patience despite the endless threat of internet disconnections, just to excel in all disciplines. With three perennial years of active physical learning and a year of fluctuating remote learning, they have come out as survivors. Xerophytes, cactus thorns, the rolled leaves of succulents, and the spikes of pine trees keep them attuned to the disheartened land creative. Today, they virtually stand with pride and honor in abundance to what Minglanilla Science High School has successfully aspired, perspired, and inspired. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the 94 Xerophytes, the potential grand survivors under intensely remote conditions, Batch Xerophytes. Resounding applause. At this juncture, let us recognize the people who have been instrumental to what they have become today. Starting with the principal, Mr. Edison De La Peña. English Department, Madam Jacqueline F. Bucau. Madam Rama B. Cabanlukit. Mr. Leo N. Nente. Madam Hanilyn A. Ramos, Miss Gladys G. Uy, Mathematics Department, Mr. James Ryan O. Barcosa, Mr. Jimjin F. Ramos, Miss Lyle S. Talico, Madam Maria Lourdes G. Ibanez, Madam Charalu F. Zapanta, Science Department, Madam Nona C. Alikaya, Madam Jade C. Bacon, Mr. Jalito M. Baga, Madam Jane R. Cedeno, Miss Jean A. Morales, Miss Crystal Joy P. Peñaranda, Madam Rumen R. Sanchez, Filipino Department, Madam Raislyn A. Balani, Madam Tressa C. Illustrissimo, Madam Charity May C. Tagudin, Madam Begonia P. Texon, Araling Panlipunan Department, Madam Charito A. Labang, Madam Cheryl A. Resma, MAPE Department, Madam Virgilia C. Nente, Ms. Angie L. Yatok, TLE and ICT Department, Madam Geraldine Basabe, Mr. Franklin O. Luwagi Jr., Mr. Lee Marshall L. Tagudin, Values Department, Madam Maria Lucille A. Lim, Mr. Dominic L. Valparaiso, Administrative Personnel, Mr. Leonard Vincent D. Aranas. To formally start this exuberant virtual completion rite, it is just and proper to start this program by recognizing the divine presence of our Lord, followed by the singing of the Philippine National Anthem, the Sugbo Hymn, and Minglanilla Science High School Alma Mater song.
Let your love surround. awit ng Pilipinas.
Realize our dreams, our world to build with love, breathe.
continue recognizing the pride and honor of this batch, it is my humble greeting to commence the program with the words of welcome from Miss Maria Ana Monique A. Rodriguez.
4 years have passed since the first time we entered the gates of Minglanilla Science High School as freshman students. 4 years of cramming for examinations, preparing for presentations, and meeting deadlines all happens in the blink of an eye. How remarkable it is to think that in those 4 years, we were able to create lasting memories and build meaningful relationships. We met what might be the best people in our lives and blossomed into the greatest individuals we can be. To our dear principal, Sir Edison de la Peña, our dynamic teachers and staff, our proud families, honorable guests, fellow junior completers, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant morning. I am honored and humbled to have the opportunity to welcome each and every one of you to this wondrous event. On behalf of the graduates, thank you for being with us on one of the biggest milestones of our lives. As bittersweet as it may sound, today marks not only an end, but also a beginning. This occasion is a goodbye to our voyage in junior high school, yet at the same time, a chance for us to welcome new horizons. Our batch has gone through a long haul. It certainly was not a tedious journey nor a monotonous one. Our lives in junior high was a roller coaster ride filled with failed performances, accomplished tasks, resounding conversations in the corridor, and laughter echoing off in the hallways. If I were to think of a word that would best describe our batch, it would be adaptive. We always coped graciously in daunting situations, which is evident in our current setup. It was difficult to have our last year as juniors in a virtual setting. However, we were not vanquished by the new normal. The hurdles we conquered helped us sprout into the Xerophytes that we are today. Even in the driest lands, our spirits will not quiver. For the past years, our educators and parents have nurtured our branches and cultivated our roots. We truly owe all that we are to these incredible people. With their guidance and our ability to be adaptive, there is no doubt that we can overcome the unknown and overpower the uncertain. To my fellow graduates, although our journey was nothing like High School Musical, we still learned a life lesson greater than Disney could ever impart. This pandemic has taught us a lot of things and gave us multiple heartaches. We all expected our last moments to be filled with class pictorials and preparations for prom nights, but instead, we spent it individually in our homes. The blackboard suddenly turned into computer screens and the face-to-face discussions became Zoom meetings. What were the odds of that? Indeed, we faced a magnitude of changes. Still, we thrived and survived. We came from different walks of life and had varied personalities. Yet, we had one thing in common: our willpower. Together, we overcame a thunderstorm and made it worthwhile. Batch Xerophytes, congratulations! I am genuinely proud of us. Each one of us embodies the values of a true mission and will surely reach new heights. Wherever the wind may take our sails, may we still continue to journey together beneath these bright blue skies and build a world where love prevails. 4 years of daily flag ceremonies, 8 a.m. classes, and monthly festivities may have passed, but 4 years of beautiful memories will forever remain. Once again, welcome and good morning.
Thank you for that welcome gesture of camaraderie, Ms. Rodriguez. At this moment, let us call in the principal of Minglanilla Science High School, Mr. Edison de la Peña, to present this year's candidate for completion, followed by the confirmation courtesy of our honored guest, the Public Schools District Supervisor of Minglanilla 1, Mr. Danilo A. Mangilimutan.
Dr. Marilyn S. Andales, Xerophytes Schools Division Superintendent, Division of Cebu Province, Department of Education. In my capacity as the school head of Minglanilla Science High School, I have the honor to present these 94 candidates for completion for school year 2020-2021, 29 of whom are males and 65 are females. They have satisfactorily completed and fulfilled the basic requirements for junior high school curriculum as prescribed by the Department of Education under the K-12 Basic Education Curriculum. They are now awaiting for your confirmation.
By virtue of the authority delegated upon me by our school's division superintendent, Dr. Marilyn S. Andales, 605, based on the facts and figures that your school principal, Mr. Edison G. De La Peña of Minglanilla Science High School, had just presented, with assurance that you have satisfactorily completed the minimum academic requirements as prescribed by the Department of Education under the K-12 curriculum, I, Mr. Danilo A. Mangilimutan, District Supervisor of Minglanilla 1, hereby confirm you completers the 16th day of July 2021 with all the honors, rights, and privileges thereunto appertaining. Henceforth, therefore, you are now eligible for transfer or admission in any public or private schools in the Republic of the Philippines. Should it be impossible for you to pursue your education, I am now turning you over to your family so that you will become effective citizens of your community and to our country as well. Congratulations, completers. Godspeed.
Thank you so much, Mr. De La Peña and Mr. Mangilimutan. Success never comes easy. It is a combination of hard work, perseverance, desire to learn, enduring a lot of sacrifices, and even surviving in the most extreme condition or situation. Every man's achievement is accompanied by profound humility in the face of great scarcity. Despite the isolation and deprivation from what is ordinarily available, the modest heart has constantly molded values with the thoughtful pleasure of wit to ensure produced creativity. Above all, success is the love of what you are doing. With this, it is just worth appreciating to give acknowledgement to students for their exemplary performance beyond limits and boundless efforts to put up the school to its pedestal of excellence. Let us all recognize these students for their unwavering passion for learning and holistic development. Ababon Miguel Ariosa, with honors. Alob Cyril James Humamoy, with honors. Amper Earl Adrian Lim, with honors. Andrade Renair Ibora, with honors. Avelino Robert Emmanuel Cañada, with honors. Bacarisas Clint Andre Bencolita, with honors. Betito James Ruby Pongkol, with honors. Cañadilla John Aaron Lumapas, with honors. Concepcion Andre Capillo. Damaulao Aaron Michael Valdivezo, with honors. Dayunot Benedict Rain, with honors. Fabiliar Michael Jeric Pacquiao, with honors. Fabroa Seth Jehoash Albaran, with honors. Famador Matthew Humphrey Villacorta, with honors. Ginto AJ Dominic Abrahan, with high honors. La Rubens Denison Riserato with honors. La Sola J. Kenneth Huesca with honors. Merquita Earl de los Reyes with honors. Mondoñedo Hezekiah Magtaas with high honors. Paran Clint Kyle Morin with honors. Pardillo Lutgar J. Zapanta with honors. Pilario Joseph Yo Alicaya with honors. Rapisora John Thaddeus Ranit with high honors. Salulugan John Kenneth with honors. Sanchez Franz Raven Rafaela with high honors. Sige Michael Dave Dejos with high honors. Tajamon Sean Richard Obeso with high honors. Trezona Keith Christian Antajas with honors. Villafranca Dan Carlo Dinopol with honors. Abeliana Bal Andrea Mejarito with honors. Abiso Althea Julia Marie Imnasin with honors. Alidon Felicity Taraya with honors. Alolor Feline Jade Alisa Bulinque with honors. Alvarez Janita Bell Del Socorro with honors. Amanense Mandela Gabriel Balbontin with honors. Amores Samantha Isabel Tadena with honors. Andaya Althea Carla Lascunya with honors. Antin John Rose Mantalaba. Aranyas Alma Marilon Abad with honors. Ariliano Angeli Kate Cortez with honors. Badaya Samantha Laika Dela Calzada with high honors. Barangot Krishna May Villar with high honors. Barwal Phoebe Pearl Orangan with high honors. Basabe Rafaela Angeline Bitia with honors. Boca Daniel Kate Mantalaba with honors. Kabatas Kari Mabert Aliganga with honors. Campania Janver Shan Montera with honors. Coronas Maricris Gubantes with honors. De Los Reyes Althea Don Yocte with honors. De La Serna Bridget Miles Medeo with honors. Dikdikan Ashera Marie Ares with high honors. Inulba Irish Dilyeza Panimdim with high honors. Escabas Rizame with honors. Figueroa Jessica Jashel Akas with honors. Pulyero Samantha Ribusi with honors. Hirasmeo Stephanie Jane Miasco with honors. Gedukyo Brazil Silva with honors. Jimeno Kila Marie Debolusan with honors. Gillian Nikki Paula Tupas with honors. Quintanar Kayla Matthew Secretaria with honors. Labajo Justin May Lapis with honors. Labuan Hannah May Alexion with high honors. Laputan Sigrid Alison Shabo with honors. Yegonas Alea Aloysa Son with honors. Mangubat Marie Kirstine Ferolino with honors. Maturan Frances Alia Salicet with honors. Montalvo Raisa Christy Cabredilla with honors. Navaluna Gliza Marie Boo with honors. Nugra Nicole Grace Javines with high honors. Valencia Hanelin Manatad with high honors. Panal Chrisline Abigail Dimol with honors. Paran Maria Daniela Abellanosa with high honors. Pelimer Giselle Marie Navarro with honors. Pilare Liana Bea Manuba with honors. Kilala Agi Zuzobrado with honors. Ranes Pichi Villela with honors. Remonte Angelica Rose Yu with honors. Reconalia Frances Ann Briones with high honors. Roa Gianna Nina Lastome with honors. Rodriguez Maria Ana Monica Lecha with high honors. Romero J. Chariz Bacaltos with high honors. Sagales Luisa Gentoba with honors. Salaza Aliana Kathleen Bartolaba with high honors. Sanchez Alina Kina Marie with honors. Sanchez Chiin Pearl Tantoy with honors. Sidorifa Charlize Feline Minancilio with high honors. Socorin Trixie Shane Garciano with honors. Tapdasan Brianna Kate Talandron with honors. Tapik Laura Eve Manayon with honors. Tigli Christophany Ann De Los Santos with high honors. Trangia Trisha Lay Tan with honors. Unavia Mary Faith Bustamante with high honors. Velosa Daniel Flores with honors. Villardon Verna Jane Rodrigo with high honors. Congratulations to all our Xerophyte completers and awardees. Indeed, these Xerophytes have enigmatically established yet another illustrious academic legacy. There were both actual shortcomings and virtual glitches that had filled this year's endeavor. Yet, Batch Xerophyte reaps what has been planted with great effort and compassion. At this point, it is an honor and privilege to listen to the words of inspiring stories and experiences from our guest speaker, who has shown great importance of diligence and positivity. Today, I should say that I am fortunate and feel elated to introduce this woman of brilliance, virtue, and simplicity. I certainly remember my acquaintance with her during the yearly summer orientation enhancement program in this institution. Her dynamic classroom engagement with the students was superb, and I would say she is one of a kind teacher of eloquence, relevance, and content. Our guest of honor has notable academic tracks with dashing flying colors. To start with, she was a graduate of Bachelor of Science in Preparatory Medicine in Southwestern University. She had a postgraduate study for a year in Cebu Institute of Medicine. Furthermore, she had complete academic requirements in Master of Education major in Chemistry in University of San Carlos. She had another complete academic requirements in Environmental Science in Miriam College and in Master of Education in Special Science Education in Cebu Technological University. She was a passer of reputable examinations like the Civil Service Professional Examination, Licensure Examination for Teachers, and National Qualify Examination for School Heads, or notably known as Principal's Test. She had an impressive teaching career and experience. She started her tenure of teaching adventures in Immaculate Heart of Mary Academy for 8 years and in Minglanilla Science High School, wherein she pioneered in creating a milestone of achievement in science and research in this institution. Her leadership, vast connection, and strong ability to plan and organize made eligible to be an Intel Teach Trainer in Department of Education, Cebu Province. Her years of experience had made her way as the school head in Comp 7 National High School. Indeed, she is a woman of pioneering spirit and willingness, a living idiom of a devoted public servant in the field of education. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to introduce to you all our keynote speaker, a devoted science teacher and school head during her time, yet her influence expands through time, Ms. Hanedina Ravandez Zafra. In behalf of our speaker, may we call in Madam Jade C. Bakken to read to us her message.
Una sa tanan, dawata palihog ang akong mainiton nga pangumusta o kinasingkasing nga pahalipay sa mga tumatapos sa grade 10 sa inalang Minglanilla Science High School. Lakip na ang mga magtutudlo o ubang mga membro sa maong eskwelahan. All of you deserve an overwhelming kudos for your perseverance during this uniquely challenging school year amidst the pandemic on top of the usual obstacles, real or imaginary. Xerophytes, a very apt name for a batch of survivors. Though, I think you were not bereaved of water, but you were deprived of things that are as vital as water. To mention, the face-to-face or physical interaction with your batchmates, classmates, schoolmates, and teachers. You missed the activities considered before as routine and mundane, like the commute to and from school, the attendance during flag raising, or even when you fall asleep in the midst of a lecture, and your sports participation in the field or on the bench. Yet, this deprivation made you innovative and creative, as you realize the true value of this and as you promise yourself not to take such things for granted. Xerophytes, behind you are all your memories these past 4 years in Women's HS, your Minglanilla Science High School, both happy and sad. Like sugar and salt, they complement each other to give one a delectable experience. Cherish this. Before you are all your dreams waiting to be realized and achieved. Your past serves as a useful tool to direct you to your goals in the next last 2 years of high school. Brace yourself with confidence, resilience, and optimism for the coming challenges. Keep going. Around you are the people who love and care for you and your well-being. Your parents, teachers, friends, classmates, and of course, the special someone, the inspiration. All of them deserve your most profound gratitude. Moreover, don't forget to thank also the others who got you here. The internet, Mr. Google, Miss Wikipedia, milk tea, Red Bull, Lipovitan, and the skill to copy and paste. Within you is all you need. God equipped you already with the raw materials that require just elbow grease. A few sweat drops from you to transform this to something awesome. You see, the Lord gave each of us two ends. One to sit on and the other to think with. Success depends on which end you use the most, according to my friend and lenders. From time to time, you'll need a helping hand, but the goal is to be self-sufficient. Remember, the best helping hand that you'll ever receive is the one at the end of your own arm, says my friend Fred Danner. So, develop your full potential, take, calculate, risks, do trial and error, get going, and pray, pray, pray. Good luck and God bless.
Thank you so much, Ms. Zafra and Madam Bakun, for that very inspiring and witty message. Nothing best describes life's shifting atmosphere but simply to move forward. This affair will be incomplete without the message coming from the best of the batch. Let us take a moment to listen to Ms. Christophany Ann S. Digley.
We were sprouting rolled leaves of succulents that got separated from the main root. Day by day, our roots slowly crawled underground. We were slowly growing with the aid of arid, rough, compounding, and head-cracking soil of research and drizzles of minimal concepts, while gradually adapting to the hot seats of long quizzes and essays. 2020 marks our lives' sudden shift. We were alienated with Google Classroom, and it seems like our conserved waters of knowledge, patience, and diligence were tested. But hey, we're seemingly dozy heads, but our minds quickly retract. That is how we call ourselves Xerophytes, the survivors. And this moment is a living witness to honor ourselves worthy of pride and respect. Ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant morning to all. Today marks the humble beginnings of how we are all blessed. It is such a great feeling to think that after many years of failures and successes, after overcoming all the challenges, here we are celebrating this, what we call, victory. And it is my greatest pleasure to conclude this amazing journey with the equally amazing ending it deserves. We confronted numerous hurdles and overcame them, all because of our determination to succeed. The fire within us burns stronger than that around us. We say ayoko na, but our actions do, laban pa. We recover from any mishaps because we know that sometimes we win, sometimes we learn. We have spent 4 years with each other, and who knew 4 years felt so short? Within these years, bonds were built and some were broken. For me, these bonds were what kept me going. Shout out to my amazing IP mates and my closest friend group. I would not be speaking here without you. And despite all of the difficulties, there is much more to be thankful for. Indeed, blessings do not come in abundance without paying tribute to the instrumental persons of our arduous journey of life. Beloved parents and family, you are the reason that we are here today. Thank you for making all of this possible. You have made the challenges and hardships bearable, and words are not enough to express how grateful we are. Throughout all the rough times, you were there ready to listen to us. You were there to bear part of our burden. You are the ones who understood us best, and I am only here today because of the unconditional love and support that my parents have given me. Mom, Dad, this one's for you. Parents, make yourselves proud. Your hard work has borne fruit. To our teachers, you made it. We were once just little sprouts with little to no knowledge, struggling to find our place in this vast world. We needed someone to help us grow, and you were that someone. You saw within us the potential, and now we have taken root. To my chill and wacky fellow students, warmest felicitations to all of us. No matter how dark or cruel the past was, let us not forget the hardships that we have experienced and the lessons that we learned in the process. Keep in mind that these will be the pillars with which we will build a better version of ourselves. Thank you. You have made another batch of junior completers. Lastly, I would like to thank the Lord for always being there to guide us. Lord, thank you for giving us the strength to endure and the opportunity to love and be loved. Never forget that He has great plans for all of us. The gardener would never let his plants wither. We were once just seeds struggling to survive in this harsh environment, and now we have found our own ways to adapt and grow. And it does not matter what we have grown into, what matters is that we have all grown beautifully. Life is tough, but so are we. We have grown into someone that the people around us can be proud of. We have all lived up to our names. And although some of us may part ways, I know that we will continue to do so. Xerophytes, keep going, keep growing, keep surviving. Congratulations to all of us.
Thank you so much, Ms. Diglin. Next in line, to lead their pledge of loyalty, may we request Mr. AJ Dominic Ginto.
We, the members of the graduating class of 2021, do hereby pledge our loyalty to our alma mater. We pledge faith and allegiance to the great virtues and high principles for which we stand. We pledge to uphold its honor throughout our lives, and may no thought, words of deeds tarnish its honor, and glory ever to be shining examples to our fellow men, in truth and knowledge imparted to us. We consecrate our lives and impose ourselves, willingly and voluntarily, without mental reservations. The duties and obligations to the noble task of rendering homage to God, of helping our parents, and serving as a strength and courage to our duties and leaders in our communities, and for the honor of Minglanilla Science High School. So help me God.
To formally conclude this momentous virtual completion rite, may we request our dearest principal, Mr. Edison De La Peña, for the closing remarks.
LGU, barangay officials, parents, faculty and staff, students, stakeholders, good day. I can't thank you enough for all the support given to Minglanilla Science High School and thus making this completion ceremony a success. To the LGU headed by Mayor Elenito Peña, thank you for the risograph and bad papers donated. To the barangay officials headed by Barangay Captain Crisanto Muanya for the improvement and covered court which someday we can use. To the parents headed by Sir Dennis Alvarez who are very supportive to all our endeavors in school. Faculty and staff who are workaholic and give extra time needed by students and the school itself. To students who volunteered and contributed making this virtual ceremony possible. To the stakeholders who donated useful materials in school during this pandemic and to the DepEd family guiding us the way as much as possible. Once again, thank you everyone. God bless.
Thank you so much, Mr. De La Peña. The stored prowess of relentless energy and dynamism has kept this batch to its unique potentials like that of a cactus, pines, and succulent plants. They have spikes and thorns, but they delicately contribute to the holistic system of biodiversity. The Xerophytes' art of conserving the waters of perseverance, humility, and diligence have kept them actively growing upward, creating stunning memories with their powerful encouragement to dream higher with positive boldness to create innovation. Nonetheless, like any beginning, there will always be a fruitful ending. To our dearest batch Xerophytes, conserve these memories to breathe in the carbon dioxide of shortcomings and breathe out the oxygen of success in the air to become a survival guide for others. Continue to transpire to inspire, aspire, and perspire the legacy of Minglanilla Science High School.
Thank you.
direction. So let's all go together towards our dreams and goals. No matter what change or what hurdles we are about to face, we will see all these through and make all our dreams come true.
Tell us why you had to hide away from.
Home Bumerang.